Okay, in this video, we shall analyze if the high interest rates that occurred between 1980 to 1986 will return. So, this is the Dow Jones chart back from 1980. We can see that the Dow Jones made a low here at 700, around 700, and during 2,706 days, it rallied up to almost 27,000, 2,700, sorry. Okay, during this time, the interest rate jumped from 7% to 18.87. And I can show you here this chart. It is written here, the prime rate climbed from 6.31 and 69, it jumped to 7.95 and up till 1887. It was the highest point since 1949. Okay, so these are years that I'm talking about. From 1980, the interest rate started to fall, and we know today it is 0.01. Okay, so what happened in Israel, for instance, during these times? It was absolutely crazy because, as you can see here, the interest rate was 48% in 78, and then it tripled in 1 year. And in 5 years, it went up to 444.88%. It was absolutely crazy these times. Okay. After that, we can see that the interest rates went down and even went to minus. And we are now, it doesn't give the 2020, anyway, we are now much lower. So what happened astrologically when the interest rates rallied so high? Jupiter went into the sign of Cancer in 79, which where it is exalted, and Jupiter aspects to Neptune. I made here the heliocentric chart, so we have here the Saturn Neptune aspects and the Jupiter Neptune aspects. Here we have the planetary positions in which signs they were in these days. And down here is the geocentric positions of Jupiter and Saturn towards Neptune. So we can see that here, when the Dow made a low, we had a square between Saturn and Neptune. Now, Saturn cycles to Neptune cause a deflation, while the Jupiter cycles to Neptune cause an inflation. Okay, so what we can see here that the interest rates went up like crazy, but the market also rallied, and more after Jupiter entered Capricorn and Saturn was in the sign of Scorpio, also together with Pluto. So Scorpio is the sign of the money, and Saturn is the sign of restriction. So after 84, the interest rates just went back to normal. You see? Under 80, this is 80, 81, 82. This is already lowering. From 81 forward, it was less and less. So 81 forward, it was less and less. And it happened when Jupiter, Saturn were in Libra, both. Now, if I forward this chart till today to see if we will have the same effect, then if this would move, it would be nice. Okay, we have it here. So here it is today's situation. If you remember that we had them in Libra, and now we will have them in Aquarius, which is also an air sign. Uranus is in opposition exactly where it was in 79, 80, 81. It was in Scorpio, and now it is in Taurus. It will be in exact opposition in the middle of May 2022. So this will be an opposition position here in middle of May 2022 of where it was before. Let me show you. 20 May 2022. No momento. Okay. So if we had Uranus in the 15 Scorpio, Uranus will be in 15 Taurus. How can I do it so you can see it? Oh, like here. Okay. So this chart shows 12th of April 78 when Jupiter moved into Cancer, where it is exalted, and Uranus was at 15 Scorpio. Now from 78 to 2022 we have 50 years. Let me see. 22, 19, 78. We have 44 years. So in 44 years, the Uranus arrived to an opposition, and I wonder what will it bring, because Uranus brings surprises towards real estate in the sign of Taurus. We can also see that Saturn was in Leo, and Saturn will be now in opposition. Pluto squares the place where Pluto was 44 years ago, and Neptune, which is the one to look at if we want to watch inflation, was in Sagittarius, and it will be now squaring that Neptune's position. So we have time to decide about loans and mortgages until May 2022, because afterwards the world will look much, much, much different than we know it today. Okay, so this is what I wanted to show you, and I hope you will take steps and you will know what to do. What to do is not to take loans, of course. Okay, good luck. Have a nice weekend.